Back to the next session of our coding and decoding. We are in the process of finding that missing figures concept. So let's go for the next question, which is based on this. Now my first question for today: 10, 100, 200, 310 question mark. This is my question, sir. Whenever a problem of this type is given, or any problem is given, what I told you, you have to check up whether it is square of natural numbers or cubes of natural numbers or factorial series or prime number series. If the given problem is not coming under these four categories, then what will I do? Basic technique: find the difference between the succeeding term and preceding term. That will give you hint for you to generate the logic for the given question. Let us see here. Difference of these two is equal to 90. 100 minus 10 is equal to 90. 200 minus 100 is 100. 310 minus 200 is equal to 110. Now 90, 100, 110. It means when I add 10 to this, I am getting the next difference. Adding 10 to this, you are getting the next difference, following the same logic. Expecting this is 120. 10 plus 90 is 100. 100 plus 100 is 200. 200 plus 110, 310. So, question mark is equal to 310 plus 120, 430. So, what is the missing figure here, sir? 430. Okay? 430. Simple. First, with the first difference only, solution is obtained. Now, note down. I am giving some time. Then, I will go to the next question. Now, sir, let's go to the next question. Question number two. 28, 33, 31, 36 question mark, and this is 30. Now look at this, sir. It is not a square of any natural number. It is not a cube of any natural number. It is not factorial of any natural number. At the same time, this is not a prime number. So, four rules are eliminated from the picture. And one more point to notice here. Second term is greater than first term. Third term is greater than second term. Once again, fourth term is less than third term. So let's go with the difference method. 33 minus 28 is plus 5. 33 minus 28 is plus 5. 31 minus 32 is 33 is minus 2. 31 minus 33 is minus 2. 36 minus 31 is plus 5. Plus 5 minus 2. Same plus 5 is again generated. Let us take this as minus 2, then it should be plus 5. If I follow this logic, look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Question mark is my fifth term. So this is equal to T4 minus 2, T4 minus 2, T4 is equal to 36 minus 2, this is 34. Now look at this, T6, T5 plus 5, according to this logic, plus 5 minus 2, so immediately plus 5. So 34 plus 5 is equal to 39. This number is generated with this logic. Therefore, missing figure is 30. Missing figure is 30. Okay, now done.
Now, sir.
Let's go to the next question. Question number 3, 125, AD, 45, 20, question mark. Now let us see some difference method. We will go AD minus 125 is minus 45. This is minus 35, 45 minus 80 minus 35, 20 minus 45 is minus 25, minus 45 minus 35 minus 25. So it should be minus 15, sir. It is minus 15. Let us see how it is generated. P2 minus P1, 80 minus 125. Is equal to minus 45. P3 minus P2. 45 minus 80 is equal to minus 35. P4 minus P3. 20 minus 45. 20 minus 45 is minus 25. P5 minus P2 then. P5 minus P2. P5 is question mark. Minus P4, P4 is 20, is equal to minus 15. So, question mark is equal to minus 15 plus 20. This is equal to 5, sir. That missing figure is equal to 5. Okay, note down the solution. Now let's go to the next question. (1, 5, 13), (25, 41), question mark. (1, 5, 13). 25, 41, question mark. Now look at this, sir. Difference of this is 4. Difference of this is 8. The difference of this is 12. 4 2s are 8. 4 3s are 12. So the difference is multiples of 4. And this is 11 minus 5 is 6. 3 minus 2 is 3 minus 2 is 1, 16, 2s, 3s, 4s, so it should be 20, because the difference is multiples of 4, therefore question mark is equal to 41 plus 20, this is 60, 41 plus 20, 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 8 is 13, 13 plus 12 is 25, 25 plus 16 is 41, 41 plus 20 is 60. Okay, sir, no doubt. Okay, now let's go to the next question. Next question, sir. 6, 17, 39, 72, question mark. Next problem is 6, 17, 39, 72, question mark. So same traditional approach. Whenever any problem is given, first I'll verify whether it is a square series or cube series or natural numbers or prime numbers. Then when we go for trial and error method, first one, the best one is find the difference. When you are calculating the difference, you will come to know, or you can generate a logic to the given problem. Look at this, sir. T2 minus T1 is equal to 17 minus 6, this is 11. T3 minus T2 is equal to 39 minus 17, 22. T4 minus T3, 72 minus 39, this is equal to 33. So T5 minus T4, question mark, minus 72, must be equal to 44, sir. 11 2s are 22, 11 3s are 33, so 11 4s are 44. Question mark is equal to 44 plus 72, 116. Question mark is equal to 44 plus 72, it is 116. Now, let us go to the next question. (5, 6, 9). 15, (?), 40. 5, 6, 9, 15, (?), 40. Look at this, sir. If we go for difference method, 1, this is 3, this is 6. Now, these two figures we don't know the difference because missing figure is in between the terms. So, with the first difference, I'm not in a position to generate any logic. So, let me go for second difference. This is first difference, sir. Let me go for second difference. Difference of this is 2. Difference of this is 3. Difference of these two numbers is 2. Difference of these two numbers is 3. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. So what will be the next differences are 4. So 6 plus 4 is 10. And it should be equal to 15. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Look at this. 1 plus 2 is 3. Next, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4, 10. Let us see here, 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 plus 6 is 15, 15 plus 10 should be equal to 25. So, question mark is equal to 15 plus 10, 25. 15 plus 10 is equal to 25. Okay. Now, with this, can I get the next number? 25 plus 15 is equal to 47. With this logic, we generated the next number. Therefore, your logic is correct. And this is correct answer. Okay, note down the solution. Let us see the next question, sir. Two comma three comma five, seven comma eleven comma question mark. Sir, looking at this question, we will get one thing. Two is a prime number, three is a prime number, seven is a prime number. Two is a prime number, three is a prime number, five is a prime number, seven is a prime number, eleven is a prime number. What is a prime number? Again, I am repeating this point. Any number which is divisible by 1 and itself. Any number which is divisible by 1 and itself is a prime number. So, this is after 11, what is the prime number? Question mark is equal to 13, sir. After 11, I get a 12. But a 12 is not an prime number because 12 is divisible by 1, 12 is divisible by 2, 12 is divisible by 3, 12 is divisible by 4, 12 is divisible by 6, and also 12 is divisible by itself. So 12 is not a prime number. 13, next natural number is 13. 13 is divisible only by 1 and itself. 13 is divisible only by 1 and itself. Therefore, 13 is the answer. Now, sir, next question. Four comma nine comma twenty-five. Question mark: 121, 169, 189, 361, 361. This is my question, sir. Look at the question once again. This 4 can be written as a 2 square. This 9 can be written as a 3 square. Look at this. This 4 I am writing as a 2 square. This 9 I am writing as a 3 square. 5 square, this question mark I am leaving blank. 11 square. 13 square, 17 square, and it is 19 square. Okay. Now, for this new series, forget about the power. Look at the numbers you have. 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number, 11 is a prime number, 13 is a prime number, 17 is a prime number, 19 is a prime number. Therefore, here, what number will come, sir? After 5 and before 11, what is the prime number you have? 7 is the only prime number, sir. After 5 and before 11, 7 is the only prime number we have. So, this is 7 square. Therefore, question mark is equal to 7 square. Question mark is equal to 7 square. Next question. 1, 9, 25, 49, 81. This is my next question, sir. Looking at the question, immediately you will get an idea, sir. This 1 can be written as 1 square. This 9 can be written as a 3 square. This 25 can be written as 5 square. This 49 can be written as 7 square. This 81 can be written as 9 square. Okay. Now, once again, forget about the powers here. If I ignore the powers for a while, base is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Base is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 1 is an odd number, sir. 3 is an odd number. 5 is an odd number. 7 is an odd number. 9 is an odd number. After 9, 10 will come. 10 is not an odd number. So, 11. So, question mark is equal to what, sir? 11. Question mark is equal to 11. Now look at the next question. One comma, four comma, eight comma, nine comma, twenty-seven comma, sixteen comma? This is my question, sir. If I take difference method 0, this is 3, this is 4, but this is 1, but this is. So, difference method is not applicable here. Difference method is not applicable here. Okay. It is not a prime numbers, but I can write this way, sir. 4 can be written as a 2 square. 8 can be written as a 2 cube. 4 can be written as a 2 square. 8 can be written as a 2 cube. Similarly, 9 can be written as a 3 square, 3 cube. Notice this. 2 square, 2 cube. For the same natural number, it is a square and it is cube. Look at this. After 2, 3 is the natural number. It is a 3 square and a 3 cube. Similarly, if I follow the logic, 4 square and 4 cube I have to get here. Then, based on this, I can write this as 1 square and 1 cube also. I can also write 1 square and 1 cube. This is already given. This I identified this way. Look at this logic one more time, sir. I'll explain this one more time. This 4 is written as a 2 square. This 8 is written as a 2 cube. Now this 9 is written as a 3 square. This 9 is 27 is written as a 3 cube. Third term is a 2 square. Fourth term is a 2 cube. Fifth term is a 3 square. Sixth term is a 3 cube. If I take up this as 4 square, based on this logic, I have to get a 4 cube here. Let me see whether it is applicable to the first term or not. This one I can write 1 square. This one I can write 1 cube. 1 square, 1 cube. 2 square, 2 cube. 3 square, 3 cube. 4 square, 4 cube. Okay, sir. Perfectly fitted here. So, question mark is equal to 4 cube. 4 into 4 into 4. 64. What is the missing figure here? 64. Let's go to the next question. One comma one, 2, 6, 24 comma question mark, comma 7, 20. Next question, sir. 1, 1, 2, 6, 24, question mark, and 7. Okay. Now, sir. Let us see. We have 0 factorial is equal to 1. From factorial notation, this concept I am taking. 1 factorial is equal to 1. 2 factorial is 1 into 2, 2. 3 factorial is 1 into 2 into 3, 6. 4 factorial is 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, 24. 5 factorial is equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, 120. 6 factorial is equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6. This is 7. This is 7. Okay. So, starting with this. This 1 can be written as 1 factorial. This 2 can be written as 2 factorial. This 6 can be written as 3 factorial. This 24 can be written as 4 factorial. So, missing figure can be written as 5 factorial. 720 can be written as 6 factorial. Okay, sir. Missing figure is identified. But look at this, first term is not considered by me. That is not allowed in logical reasoning. So, this one I am writing as 0 factorial without missing the logic. Okay, without missing the logic, first one how I am writing 0 factorial. So, this one is 0 factorial, this one is 1 factorial. This one. So, that missing figure is identified as 5 factorial. That missing figure is identified as 5 factorial. Note down the solution. Okay, sir, look at the next question. Look at the next question. One comma two, 6, 7, 21, 22, 66, 67, question mark. This is 1, 2, 2, 6, 6, 7, 21, 22. This way it is going on. How to write this? One way, difference of these two numbers is 1. 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 But how can I get two numbers there? One's missing figure only we have to calculate. Look at this, sir, here. Into 2, into 3. Into 3 here. 2 3s are 6. If I take this difference into 3, this is into 3. Again, this difference, if I take into 3, so this difference should be into 3. This difference should be into 3. So 67 into 3. 3, 8s are 6, 3, 6 are 18, 201. Missing figure is equal to 201, sir. This is one way of finding out. Let us see the next method what we have. Alternative approach. 126, 721, 22, 66, 67, question mark. Now here first term is not included, sir. First term is not included. So I am including first term also, plus 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 into 3. 2 into 3 is 6. Plus 1 into 3, plus 1 into 3, plus 1, so it should be into 3. Finally, into 3 is the answer. 67 multiplied by 3, here also 67 multiplied with 3. But in the first method, 1 is not considered by me. 1 is not considered by me. Here, I considered 1 also. So, you can take any one. Ultimately, answer is 201 only. Look at this, question mark is equal to 67 into 3. 201. Here also. But this 1 also we have to consider, sir. So, I prefer second one rather than first one. Okay. Now let us see the next question, sir. Let us see, sir, first two numbers if I consider. 24 is exactly half of this number. T2 is equal to T1 by 2. 48 by 2. 24. Let me see how I can generate third term. 4 into 24. T2 into 4. 24 into 4, 96. And verify whether this logic is applicable for the whole series or not. So, this is multiplied to obtain this. T4 is equal to T3 divided by 2. 96 divided by 2, 48, sir. T5 is equal to T4 into 4, 192 into 4, 768 divided multiplication divided multiplication. So this is 768. Missing figure is equal to D5 question mark. This question mark is equal to 24 divided by this half, 48 divided by 2, this is multiplied with 4, this is divided by 2, this is multiplied with 4. So then I have to divide. Look at this, sir. This divided by 2, multiplied with 4, divided by 2, multiplied with 4. Then it should be divided. Then it should be divided. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is D6. 1 minute. I'll write this one more time. D5 is equal to, sir, D4 into 4, 48 into 4, 192. Now D6 is equal to D5 divided by 2, 192 divided by 2, 2 will go 9 times, 18, 6. Missing figure is, question mark is 96. 96 is the question. Okay, sir. Note down the solution.